And here is the Writer's Almanac for Tuesday, the 15th of September, 2020. It's the birthday of the best-selling novelist of all time, and that was Agatha Christie, born Devon, England, 1890. Her books have sold more than 2 billion copies in 103 languages. She was born to an upper-middle-class family, homeschooled by her mother till she was 16. Father died when she was young, which threw the family into financial straits. Christie worked as a nurse during World War I, began writing stories, mostly about spiritualism, the paranormal. Then in 1920, a novel called The Mysterious Affair at Stiles, which featured a Belgian detective named Hercule Poirot. The book was a hit. She was off and running. Her formula, fairly simple. Assemble 8 or 9 people in some place, a snowbound train, a girls' school, in a remote country house, add a murder, often by poison. In one novel, a child dies by bobbing for apples. In another, a character is electrocuted while executing a chess move. She often employed red herrings, double bluffs. In one book, the killer turns out to be a dead man. In another, the killer is a child. And in another, it turns out that all 12 suspects have committed the crime together. In 1927, Agatha Christie created the character of Jane Marple, who appears in 12 novels, Nosy Old Woman and Amateur Detective. Agatha Christie, who for most of her life pumped out one novel per year, said, 3 months seems to me to be quite reasonable to finish a book if you can get right down to it. It was on this date in 1963, Sunday morning, a bomb went off in the 16th Street Baptist Church in Birmingham, Alabama, frequent meeting place for leaders of the civil rights movement. It killed 4 schoolgirls, Cynthia Wesley, Carol Robertson, Addie Mae Collins, Denise McNair. A member of the Ku Klux Klan named Chambliss was convicted of possessing dynamite without a permit, sentenced to a $100 fine, 6 months jail time, found not guilty in the murders of the 4 girls. A later investigation revealed that the FBI, under the direction of J. Edgar Hoover, had suppressed key evidence against him. He was retried in 1973, found guilty, sentenced to life in prison. Here's a poem for today by Julie Cadwallader Staub entitled Joy. Who could need more proof than honey? How the bees with such skill and purpose enter flower after flower, sing their way home to create and cap the new honey just to get through the flowerless winter. And how the bear, with intention and cunning, raids the hive, shovels pawful after pawful into his happy mouth, bats away indignant bees, stumbles off in a stupor of satiation and stickiness. And how we humans can't resist its viscosity, its taste of clover and wind, its metaphorical power. Don't we yearn for a land of milk and honey? Don't we call our loved ones honey? All because bees just do over and over again what they were made to do. Oh, who could need more proof than honey to know that our world was meant to be and was meant to be sweet? A poem entitled Joy by Julie Cadwallader Staub, used by permission here on the Writer's Almanac, funded by donations from listeners like you, now available on PRX for distribution by your local radio station. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.